Good morning, guys, from the car. Welcome to a new vlog. So I had a super cozy, dark morning. It's getting so dark here now. It was supposed to be snow today. It isn't. So I'm a bit sad, but also a bit nice since I'm gonna drive into the city and pass the city today. So it would be nice with no traffic jams. And I have winter tires, as I told you in the last vlog, but even though I have it, maybe not everyone has it, so doesn't really save me. Leon had his 5th birthday and it was so cute. Now I have a big baby boy. He's not a baby anymore, but he's a baby to me. We had such a cozy day. We were just like hanging out all day. I took him, just him, during the day, and we went and like had cinnamon buns in the morning at a cafe, and then I took him to the mall. No, he's calling. He got a watch where you can call. Let me see if you can show. See. I'm just gonna answer. Hej älskling.
Hej.
Hej. Jag hoppar in I bilen nu så jag kommer.
Ja.
Okej.
Älskar dig.
Älskar dig. Puss puss.
Ses snart.
Ja, puss.
Du kan lägga på.
Ja, okej, puss. It's so cute. So he got this little watch where he can call. And he called so many times. I love him so much. Anyways, after that we went to the mall. We did some shopping. My mom and my sister come and met us up. And then we had lunch together. He did some more shopping with them. Oh, it was such a cozy day. And then we went to Jon's house where we had some friends. Or he invited some friends and his mom and dad and blah, blah, blah. It was super cozy. Such a good day. He had the best time. And yeah. Now I'm going to go and drop off their ice skates. Since they're going ice skating today. And then I am going into the city with my sister. Or not into the city. I'm going past the city. But I will show you when we're there. But first, go drop off the ice skates to the kids. Now it's nice that we live like 2 minutes car ride from each other. Just like swing by, drop it off. It's also Jon's dad's birthday and he's here, so I have to sing. Okay, let's go. Here we have some snow. I saw it on the road as well. Wait, let me just turn down the volume. I saw it on the road as well. So it has been snowing, but not where I live. So I just cuddled a bit with the kids and sang to Anders. You know, I'm so happy that they're still part of my family, you know? So I'm really happy we have the same relationship, really. Like, a big happy family, and I love that. They're the nicest, and I will always love them. So they're still part of my family, you know? It's nice to have them here and like hang out a bit yesterday and today, and yeah. Anyways, now we are going into the city. I just texted my sister that we're on our way, and I'm gonna actually go check my skin. Now it's fully back to normal, almost. It doesn't hurt anymore. But both me and my sister are gonna go. One of my friends, she works with a brand that is really good for like pigmentation and stuff. So I've been thinking about going there for so long, but then I got this breakout, so we pushed it. So today we're going there just to like, they're gonna check my skin and like see what would be good for me and for my sister. So yeah, let's go there. So,
yay.
Sister's here. We both did a facial treatment and talked so much about, because both of us have some, you have more pigmentation, but yeah. I also have like uneven skin. So that's the goal for 2025. But now we did like a calming treatment for my area, like anti-inflammatory stuff. And you did, what did you do?
I don't know. Some kind of like peel.
Glow treatment.
Glow treatment.
Like she needs more glow.
Yeah, right now maybe.
Yeah, but now it's also super cold. I think it's gonna start snowing soon. It is 1 degree, feels like 0.5.
Yeah.
But now let's go home and get some other work done. See you at home. Peace.
Peace.
So I am back home again and it's getting dark already. I just have to get used to this weather now and the light situation, but it looks like it's about to start snowing. And I'm actually pretty excited. I did a little quick makeup because I'm heading somewhere later tonight. But this part of the video is in collaboration together with Songmont. And if you haven't heard of it, you've probably seen it. Because I've been wearing this since the day I got it. And the only one I've used. And it's this incredible bag. You've probably seen me wear this every single day. So I got it and I got so... Like when I opened it, I was like, oh my god, this is such a perfect everyday bag. It's so chic and like versatile. I will show you many ways to wear it because It's incredible. Like the leather and the quality of it. And it has an incredible price tag for the quality. Like you really feel it when you have it, you're like, oh my god, this feels like such a luxury bag. So how I usually wear it for everyday life is like this. I thought I would show you like how I would style it. So this is the classic look to wear it. Or like I can wear it like this or like this. But I just wish you guys could see all the details of it. You see? Like, and these are fade resistant and this leather is very, very nice. Anyways, these come in other colors as well and I would love it in every single color because it's the perfect everyday bag and it also comes in different sizes. This is the small. Ah, it's so good. So I thought I would show you. I would either wear it, you know, now I have a pair of like lace pants, classic top, let's say Converse, and this. I can insert some photos here. Like I've had it with every single outfit. I just grab it. I don't even unpack it, you know, when you usually change the bag. So I would wear it like this for the day. And then here comes the fun part. You just easily pull it out like this. And then you do it like this. And I love when a brand has really thought several ways. Like how can I wear this in more ways? So this bag actually looks like three different bags. So then, let's say I want to have it as a night bag, you know, go for dinner. I want something that is more, you know, smaller. Then I just pull it in here. And it looks like a completely different bag, you see? And then you can just have it like this, you know, like a tiny dinner bag. I shouldn't have worn black, I see that now, because you don't see it. But how cute! And they got inspired by the moon to create it. So it's like, it looks like a tiny little moon. But how cool. So this is two bags in one. And then you could also have the longer strap on the bigger bags. But then you could also play with it even more and do it like this. So you just take the handle and it's like a little, you know, you can carry it like this. How cute. I mean, so, so good. But what I mostly use is the first with the strap for everyday use. So it's seriously the only bag I use at the moment. It's just perfect. Even though I've used it every day for the last like 3 months, the quality is just the same. So I guarantee you, you will love it, you will wear it. I sometimes think like price per use to calculate and it's perfect. So this I would also style with like heels and this one. But it also works so well together with like a white outfit, a gray, brown, you know, a black bag. You can never not use it. They also have another one. Let me show you. Okay, I changed into a wider outfit because this little bag that I'm gonna show you is the other one that if I changed bag from the Luna, I go for this one. The small chocolate in vanilla. And like the detailing on these, it's just like this strap. Pull it down and then you open it. And then you have a little back pocket here. It's also like so useful. I put like receipts and stuff I need to save here. Now you can click it together if you want to make it tighter or open it if you want it, you know, a bit wider. And then you have these straps. They're the classic, you know, shoulder like this. Oh, it looks so good. And then you also have it. You can do the long, you know, if you want to have it more like this when you're like running, doing things. And this is how I would style it. But I also wear this with everything. Like what I love with these is that they're so classic. They work with everything. I'm so excited about this collaboration because I love giving you guys fashion tips, but I haven't done that much lately. So I'm excited to get back into it because as you know, I love fashion. Now having my own house and everything, it's like, okay, I can finally go back to the one I used to be and be like inspired, wear outfits that are fun and all these things. If you're looking for a bag, perfect gift to someone. If you're a guy watching this and don't know what to get to your girlfriend, here you have it. Now you know, she will love it. Or even for yourself, like the perfect classic bags that you would wear and have forever. And I promise you like the quality and the detailing. I'm obsessed. But I will have links to them below and check it out. Now I am gonna go get a coffee and then later tonight I'm heading to an event. So yeah, I just have to decide what to wear. Okay, let's go. Thank you.
Läget? Nej, alltså jag, min puls just nu är liksom, jag har hunnit klämma in 2 samarbeten sedan jag kom hem vid 1.
Ja, jag förstår.
Det är ingen snö här i alla fall än. Man tänkte, jag som bor ute på landet borde ju ha mer snö, eller?
Hey guys, it is the day after, and as usual, I came home too late, so I didn't end the vlog. But I thought I have a few things that I want to show you. First of all, look outside! We have the first snow of the year. It's not a lot, but it's been like super stormy and chaos on the roads, but also so cozy! I'm so excited! Even though I'm not probably going out today, since I have a lot of stuff to do at home and some work to get into. But yesterday, did a podcast with my sister, as you saw, and then went to the hockey game with my mom. It was a good game. And I know, I've been like, yeah, I'm into hockey right now, and a lot of you guys know why and everything. But I've always been into hockey, but now a little bit extra. I've been keeping a part of my life a bit for myself for a while. So yeah, trying to sneak it in a bit here and there when I feel ready for it, you know? But yeah, very happy. And it was a lot of fun. And the team won that I'm rooting for. Again, they're on a good roll. But I'm gonna show you. I got a new couch downstairs. So I don't think I fully showed it to you, but let me go down and show you.
Okay, are you ready? Da 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 da. Here it is, the new couch. It fits so much better. Like, I don't know. Maybe you guys don't see a big difference. But I'm thinking if I should move this one over here to have it with the TV, or if I should keep it there for the fireplace. But this one you can move. It's not detached, like, or attached to the couch. So you can put it in the middle. That's what I love. So yeah, here we have the new living room space. Also got a little plant here to add some green stuff. And then here on the wall, I have this hat, I have this mirror,
hello,
that I want to put up there, but I kind of like the hat, but it's a bit summery, but I like the vibe with the hat and stuff, you know? You know I love this style. Earthy tones, a bit, you know, not so typical Swedish, I would say, like Scandinavian with a touch of, not Scandinavian style, with the plants and the hats and stuff like that. When is it okay to put up the Christmas tree? I'm asking for a friend because I am very excited to get some Christmas decorations going. I will probably wait for the kids, but when is it okay? Can someone just tell me? Because I'm excited. But very happy with this room, how it turned out. An extra living room, and I'm thinking like the kids, when they have friends over, they can be here and watch movies or hang out. If the grown-ups have dinner upstairs, or the other way around, like when the kids went to bed, went to sleep, they sleep in there. We usually watch TV upstairs when they're asleep, because that's where the kitchen and everything is. But yeah, this room is, it's a bit more comfortable. So with the fireplace and everything, might start using this room more now when the couch is finally here. I mean, even if it's super dark outside, and like it's not super dark, but there's still such good light in this house. Can't wait for the bar stools to arrive. But this is my work spot for the day. We have some toys, balloons, since we're gonna have Leon's birthday party on Sunday with my family. It was a bit too crowded at Jon's house, but I was still there with his side of the family and everything. So Leon was very excited to have 2 birthday parties, so yeah. But what I wanted to say as well was, if you guys have anything you want me to talk about on the vlog or show or do more of, that would be super nice to get some feedback on. You guys know when I was on my vlog game, we were mostly traveling and, you know, doing all these things. It's a bit trickier for me here in Stockholm. But do you know what? I have my first ski trip booked. Soon it's gonna be booked. It's not fully booked yet, but like the dates are set and the location and everything. And it will be mid-December. Can't even try to tell you how excited I am to go ski again. I'm very, very excited. You guys know I love skiing, so. You hang out, you get some exercise, it's nice weather, people, friends. But yeah, I'm just gonna cook something because I need some breakfast, and then I'll get back to you. Okay, this looks super sad, But it's one of my favorite snacks, or like, if you want to have a small breakfast or a little snack. All you need is Swedish caviar, an egg, and a little, what do you call it? Knäckebröd. But you see, this hard bread. So this is all you need for a typical Swedish sandwich that probably only Swedes like. Because this, and I also go for this cheaper Swedish caviar because I actually think it's so much better. It's extra mild. I think the regular one, the Kalles caviar, I think it's a bit too strong for my taste. So I prefer this one, the extra mild. It looks like the budget version, and it is. It's better. So I think if you're not Swedish, maybe this one will taste better. But you will probably not like it. And you probably won't even be able to get it. But this combo, mwah! Let me show you how I do it. Here in Sweden, we even have like the egg cutters, you know? But I haven't managed to buy that yet into the new house. So nowadays, I just take a regular knife. I don't really have a good setup for this, but here we have the bread, and then I just cut it onto the sandwich. Do you guys miss the Janni cooking show? Because it feels like it was a bit better before the cooking show, when I actually made food. But I will start doing that again if you want, because I have some recipes that I really want to show you guys that I love. And I'm gonna use a lot of caviar. This is how it looks. And then I take this one, and then I just add quite a lot, because you can never have enough. The best Swedish snack there is. Cheers. That's how you eat it on a hard bread. Still worth it. So now my snack is in the belly, and now I am actually gonna start this day and get some work done and get into it. But I'm very excited about it being snowy. This is the first time I see this house in snow. So I've seen late summer, fall, and now winter. It's always fun to see how a house is in during different seasons, because you never know. We'll probably have to do a lot of snow shoveling, since we have also the little terrace upstairs. That's fine, you know, when you have this view, that's fine. But I hope you enjoyed this vlog, and don't forget the Songmont links I have below. Check it out. I'm sure you're gonna love them as much as I do. That's it from this vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. See you soon. Ciao, ciao. Mwah!